I'm a big believer in not, you know, creating a plan that becomes, you know, the focus. You know, I think the problem with plans are you have to follow them. My brother and I wanted to make a little newspaper because we found a little printing system in a garage sale. And then we were trying to think what we would print, and then we decided we'd like to mow people's lawn and send them a printed thing that would mow their lawn, and we ended up like mowing everybody's lawn in the neighborhood. So that was kind of the, like, this ain't so bad, I'll go buy a pair of Nike Wimpletons. It was on, right? I mean, I was mowing lawns and buying my own shoes and bicycles and stuff as a kid, and that just wasn't gonna stop. Wanted to be in control of that. Procrastination's a part of my story. but I think there's an interesting thing where I'm kind of always working. You know, if I find a few minutes, it's nothing anymore to open it up, check my emails, look how to write somebody an email. You know, in the early days, the best ideas came from me because I was always sitting around thinking in search of a great idea. I have collected a group of people around me that I think are very interesting visionaries and people that add to, and so I think my best ideas come from a small group at work where we can kind of build on each other's thoughts. The advice that I would give myself would be, you know, don't be real hard on yourself. You know, somehow I think over the years I've thought that I was supposed to know how to do everything and have it all figured out.